Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. Most of us don't pay attention to things that develop slowly, and sea level rise is one of them. There's a report recently from the Virginia Institute of Marine Science that says that the sea level rise is accelerating on both coasts. Now there's a New Hampshire coastal flood risk summary by the Institute for the Study of Earth, Oceans, and Space at the University of New Hampshire that has a similar conclusion. And we'll show you that projected impact of sea level rise on the New Hampshire seacoast in a minute with my guest, Cameron Wake, who is research professor at the Institute for the Study of Earth, Oceans, and Space at the University of New Hampshire and a co-author of the Coastal Flood Risk Summary. Welcome, Cameron. Nice to have you.
Thanks for having me, Fred. Happy to be here.
With the reports that the large ice sheets in Greenland and other places are melting faster than expected, what are you seeing for sea level rise on the New Hampshire coast and the New England coast in general?
Yeah, what we're beginning to see is that the rate of sea level rise is increasing. So it's been increasing for the last 100 years. We've seen about 7 to 8 inches of increase on our seacoast. But over the course of the past 20 years, that rate of increase has actually doubled. And the reason that it's doubled is that we're seeing more, as you've said, of these big ice sheets, Greenland and Antarctica, are beginning to disintegrate. And there's some very interesting and complex dynamics related to how the ice shelves drain those big ice sheets. But yeah, those ice shelves are starting to crack off more. And really, that's what's driving this increase in the rate of sea level rise.
Now, sea level rise, as you know better than I, goes into groundwater inland. And we have a map that your study created showing the projected rise in groundwater along the New Hampshire seacoast from, it looks like, Seabrook up to Portsmouth.
And so this is some wonderful research by Jane Nodd, who got her PhD at UNH, showing that how much that groundwater is going to rise inland. And what you see is this is the percentage of groundwater rise compared to how much sea level rise there's going to be. So the red colors are sort of the 90 to 100%. So if we see 2 feet of sea level rise, we'll see sort of a foot and a half to 1.8 feet of groundwater rise in the red. And then as you go to the blues, the amount of groundwater rise will be a little bit less. But we see impacts going in 5 to 6 miles from the coast. So when we think about a big coastal storm, we think just the shoreline's affected. But on the long term and on these tidal cycles, we're going to be seeing inland flooding as that sea level lifts up the groundwater.
And so that impacts roads that are low, built on low level, and I assume homes and maybe even cemeteries.
Yeah, cemeteries. I think a really important aspect of this is going to be the effect on septic systems. If you have a sort of a septic system that's close to groundwater and you get that water rising over it, it's no longer going to work. And also drinking water wells. Right. Are going to be affected by this. And so if you think about two things that are really important about your home is fresh water in and waste out, and both of those could be significantly impacted by groundwater rise.
Now, going back to the tides, the sea level rise on the coast itself, here's a graph, and maybe you can explain it. You can see projections of the sea level rise at Seabee Island. That's where the Portsmouth Shipyard is located. And these are, you can see in the shaded blue, numbers 3, 4, and 5 looks like the most likely rise.
Correct. So what we're seeing here is what our projections for sea level rise are out to the year 2150. And we've looked at a whole range of different processes that can drive a sea level rise, including the melting of the big ice sheets, increases in temperature of the ocean water that allows it to expand, the sinking of the coast in New England. And we followed sort of the scientific literature and looked at the probabilities. So the most likely amount of sea level rise by 2050 is going to be about a foot, but there's a 1 in 100 chance it could be 2 feet. By 2100, we're looking more at a range of 2 to 4 feet, but there's a 1 in 100 chance it could be 5 feet, and there's a 1 in 1,000 chance it could be as much as 9 feet.
And the state is using federal money, as you know, Cameron, to see how that sea level rise will impact the seacoast.
Yeah, so there's good news and bad news here, right? The bad news is that sea levels are rising and they're going to rise for centuries, and every coastal region around the world is going to have to deal with this. The good news is, as you started with, it's a slow-moving storm. This is something that we can actually plan and prepare for. And what DES, and with some help from some federal dollars, as well as a number of researchers at UNH, are really talking with communities, identifying their specific vulnerabilities, And then the communities then have to decide what it is they're going to do about protecting those important resources.
Aaron Waite, research professor at the Institute for Earth, Oceans and Space at the University of New Hampshire. Thank you.